Let's look at this question. Consider two different cloth cutting processes. In the first one, n circular cloth pieces are cut from a square cloth piece of side A in the following steps. The original square of side A is divided into n smaller squares, not necessarily of the same size. Then a circle of maximum possible area is cut from each of the smaller squares. In the second process, only one circle of maximum possible area is cut from the square of side A and the process ends there. The cloth pieces remaining after cutting the circles are scrapped in both the processes. The ratio of total area of scrap cloth generated in the former to that in the latter is. Okay, the answer to this question is 1:1. That I can figure out right away. I'll just try to show you the reasoning. Say if you have this large square, you have this large square and you have this circle. This would be the region scrapped. Can you see for a square to the region scrapped, that ratio will remain constant. So for this large square, say if you had how many? Let me say you divide it into 16 smaller squares. You would have your circles placed in these 16 regions. The ratio of square to scrapped region will remain the same. Even when you divide the larger square into 16 small parts, for every small square, the ratio of circle to the scrapped region will remain the same. Just that there are 16 circles now, the ratio would effectively become 16 times of whatever this is. But can you see that for these small squares, when they are supersized to 16 squares, the ratio will remain the same. So regardless of whether you have just one circle fitted or multiple circles fitted, the area of the scrap cloth is going to be identical. Therefore, the answer to this question has to be 1:1.